Hi all, welcome to my channel, welcome to my world. This is The World of Wayne, and we're now doing the very final episode, pack 12 of the Agora Models release, a build the 2A6 Leopard Tank. So this is going to be another model put to bed. I can't wait to actually get this done. I'm going to have to cut the lawn so that I can actually have it running around the lawn after this. Hopefully we can do this all in one go. Not a lot to do. It's going to be a lot of connecting of wires. We're also going to actually be replacing some parts, which I'm guessing wasn't strong enough in the previous build. So we're updating those, especially the springs for the road wheels. But you'll see that as we go along. Now, if you want to get this for yourself, I have put the link down here to the Agora Models website. You can get this all the way from pack one, but for the final time, without further ado, let's get cracking. So it's going to start in this pack with stage 93, which I've got here. Let's just open this up. Not quite sure what this is at the moment. Looks like a sand covered wall, I guess. I don't know, it has got a screen in here. We'll figure that one out afterwards. I've got a funny feeling that's something to do with the remote control, but I'll put that to one side. We also have some screws, which are ACP screws, which again, I'm going to put them to one side because the only thing that I do need from this is this little detail right here. And this section is actually just going to be glued onto this here. Now, the best way to line this up, you see we've got a little notch in that area there. If you line that up with that sort of thing there, it's going to go there. And that sort of matches the pattern that's on that side as well. So what I'm going to do is just put some glue on this and put this into place. Now, I've only put some glue in the two faces that we got there. That should be enough to hold this no problems at all. And I'll get this in. Just hold that down. There we go. That's in, and that's all there is to do in that stage. Now I'm just going to take the little man out of here because I'm going to be turning this upside down. On stage 94, we've got some cables to put in. Now what I am going to do before I do that is I am going to take out these that we put in the last pack. I don't want to crush these if this is going upside down. And I'll put these back in again afterwards. We're okay to have the gun there, I think. Okay, let's turn this upside down. And there we go. So as you can see in stage 94, we've got lots of cables here. So I'm going to take my time over this so we can make sure that we put the right cables in the right place. So the first thing I want to do in this section here, we have got this cable here with adhesive on the back of it. I want to take off this adhesive. And with the resistor facing upwards and the cables facing down, I want to put this sort of in position here. Just like that. Push that in. Now, as you can see, all of these cables are actually labeled up. So this is cable F here, and cable F is going to be going into the top point just there. I'm checking the pins aren't bent, and I'm going to make sure this is in all the way. There we go, cable F is in. I'm going to be taking this side of the controller we just put in, and I'm going to putting it into plug F, which is this long one just in the center here. Again, checking the pins are the right way around and pushing that into position, making sure it's all the way down. On the other side here, we've got plug S. That's going to go into the plug just at the bottom of where we just put the plug F. And that's plugged in as there as well. And then the other side of this controller here, which says plug S as well, that's going to go underneath what we've just put in there. There we go. That's those wires in. So the next wire we're going to be putting in is plug G, which looks like that. That's just going to go into part G just on this board here. So I'll get that one in. And that one's all the way in. Excellent. We've got plug V
here, which is coming from this motor. It's going to go into V on this side of the control board. Excellent. Plug I, this is labelled I, is going into this socket just here. Now this is where it gets confusing. Plug F here is actually going to go into X on the control board. So I'll put that one in. And then finally plug S here is going to go onto Z on the control board. I know, it's confusing. But that's where they go. That's all the electrics in place there. Just onto that control board, all the plugs are filled. Now we're going to move to the internal ones here. So we got plug E. We'll be going into E on the control board. Going to be a little bit tricky this one because we are under the lip for this. But I have lined it up. We got plug J here. Should be going into there. Plug R into R. Plug U into U. Plug Q into Q. Plug Y into Y. And then plug P into P. And then finally plug A just into port A. Now you will notice I've taken out the screws from all around here. What I'm going to do is I'm putting them back in, but I'm going to make sure that when they're in, they're not very tight. I'm just doing them until there's resistance, because I want there to be free movement when this turns for the turret. So I'm not making these tight at all, just enough to keep that in line with all the cogs there. As you can see, not tight at all. So that's going to be free to turn in with this cog here. So the only one that hasn't got a plug at the moment is this long one across the center here. Now all of these cables are going to be used for the remote control, so we can put them to one side. I'm going to turn this back over again because I've got a tiny detail for the gun to go in, which is basically a little tiny clip here. So that's going to go on the outside, clipping that in, and then the bottom of it is going to go into the little hole that we've got on the side of the hatch there, and it's screwed in with an even tinier silver screw. I mean, look, check that out. Let's get this one in. Pretty hard to get that started, but there you go. That's gone in. Helps to have a screwdriver, which will actually fit into that. But there we go. That's that little mount on just there. I don't actually need the top of the tank now, so I can put this to one side. And I'm now going to be bringing over the bottom section here, because I've got to remove all the road wheels and change the springs inside them. They've actually gave us replacement springs, as you can see here, for both sides. Now to get at these, what we need to do is this one here first, take this out, just like that, and then that will give us access to the screws here, which we need to take out. I'll do one and then we'll come back and see them all complete. So just get this one out here, gently put it up, take out the old spring, which looks like that. So this is actually the left side I'm doing, just realized that. So I've got to put this on here. It's going to be a lot tighter than the other one, just so you know. Put the first screw in, and there you go. This is a lot more, it's got a lot more torsion than the other ones have. These are quite loose, this is quite strong. So I'm going to replace all of these on the left side first, and then the right side. And there you go,
that's both of those sides all got new springs. Now, I'm going to bring over the tracks. Now, there's a little discussion online about these. They want these tracks to be 79 tracks long. In the community, they're saying that's slightly too tight. We definitely need 81. Now, at the start of this build, they told us to use 81, and I've got 81 here. But at the end of the build, they're asking us to take two off.
So I have actually done that. I've taken two off. So there's 79 little individual tracks on the main track. And now I'm in the process of looping these together.
So I've taken off this section here. Should I need to adjust the tension afterwards? We're going to do it with this screw here. I've got the track. I'm going to put this onto the tank. We want to make sure that these teeth here are engaged in this section, like we can see there. And then I'm going to be putting this roller here back in on this side to hold all of this in. Now, just looking at this here, my guess once I've got this in just looking at how this is laid out, I'm going to say I think that's just about right. But that's the first track on there. I'm going to do the same on the other side. Now, I'm not going to put these back on until I'm happy with the tension of that. But if I just lie this down now, the tank is now on its tracks. And then what I can do now is just connect these two wires up together. Quite a tough thing, but they hold itself together just like that. And we're going to be putting the two sides of the tank together. So, bringing up the turret section, I'm going to connect this lead here, which is L, into L on this board here. Just like that. Making sure no other cables coming out here. Now, this long ribbon cable that we got here is going to go into Z1. Which is just next to the cable we've just put in. And that's all pushed in. Cable D here is going to go next to that. Cable ZB is going on the top. Just here. Cable B here is just going to go on this side, and cable C is just going to go into this side here, which just leaves cable H from the back, which is going into this port just here. So they're all in. Just hide this wire so it's not going to bite when I put the two sections together, because when we're actually screwing these parts together, it's going to be connecting by these lugs here, so we want to make sure that they're clear. Okay, the last lead to put in is this ribbon cable, which is going to go into this top section here. So we need to do two things at once here. And there we go, that one's in. Put the top and the bottom together. Again, just making sure none of those points that we've got on the side are actually touching. And there we go. That's all together. And I'm just going to turn it upside down. Or probably actually best just on its... gently turning it upside down. Because I'm going to be putting YP screws into these six holes here. One... do one at the front. And then I'll put the rest of these in. Turn this back over. Just going to put these aerials back in at the back. We've got these wires here to put in. So they sort of hook over this section here. Go underneath this section just here. Get that all the way through, like that. Underneath this section at the back here, put another end onto this, just a case of screwing this on. You can put a drop of glue in there to hold that as well. We've then got this section here, which came in stage 67. That's just going to clip into the holes that we've got here. Push this in, just like that. And that connects just at the back. I don't know if you can see that. Whoops, just like that. I'm going to repeat on the other side. Now I've just got the last two caps to put on here. One and two. Excellent. And that is the finished tank. So I'm going to put this to one side. So this now leads on to the remote control. So in stage 95, I'll just get this open. We've got some of the circuitry and screen for the remote. And we could just put that just to one side. In stage 96, we've got another circuit board in here and some little controls. And we do actually get to do something with these. What we're actually going to do is put this little knob here over this spindle. It has got sort of like a horizontal pattern. So horizontal pattern is a horizontal shape. And push that on like that. So we can now operate that like that. On the other side, we've got these little indicators here. They're just going to go on these buttons. They look like indicators. What they actually are, I'm guessing, turns. Very good. Bring over the cover that we had from the previous stage. We're going to be putting this section into the remote with the glass in there. It's going to go in this section here. Just gently letting gravity help me. It's going to go in like that. That's held in with CP screws. Need 5 screws here to keep this in. And that's that stage complete. Let's bring up 97. Exactly the same way as before. Put this knob on this side. There you go. So now that one goes up and down. We have these going over the buttons here. Perfect. And then this one is going over this section just there. Another button there. Once again, we're going to offer this to the remote like that. And held in once again with CP screws. Just holding that glass in place. That's now that stage complete. Another circuit board here in issue 98. This time we've got an aerial here, but I want this to go on this way so that the loops here go on upwards like that. We're then going to offer that to the remote. Just like that, held in once again. You guessed it, CP screws. I want to peel the screen off of this part. Make sure I don't put my fingers on it. And then put this face down into this area here. Like that. And then this is where I need my cables from issue 94. So the first cable I need is the red, white, green and blue one. That's going to plug into this side. Make sure that's in all the way. And the other side of this is going to go into the bottom board here. There we go. That's that one in. On the other side here, we've got the big ribbon board. So this is going to go in here like this. This way around, make sure you get it the right way around. Make sure it's pushed in all the way as well. Excellent. And then again, plug the bottom one into the board here. And then we've just got this lead here going into the board of the screen, just like that. And the other side's just going into this bottom board again here. Perfect. So that's all of those in place. Take the back section here, and we want to plug this power section just into this last plug that we've got here. Make sure this wire is contained in here, and then we're going to close this off. And then once again, holding that together with CP screws. Now just opening the battery box up here, we're going to need AA batteries, so I'll have to get some of those together. And we do have an on-off switch here for the remote control. So we could turn that on and off, but there we go. That's the screen and this in place, just making sure all the buttons operate when I press them, which they do. In stage 99, I don't even know what this is. It looks like a speaker. Not sure what we're doing with it. And we also need stage 100. And we're going to be plugging these two parts together. So we've got a smaller plug and a larger plug. They can only go in one way. So the larger one on this side. And then the smaller one. Bring these together by slotting them in like that. And then we're going to be putting this top section on here, which goes in just like that there. And that's held in from the other side with these silver ACP screws. Now this is powered by its own batteries as well. So I'll get all of these screws in. And there we go, that's that complete. Now this one, I'm just going to take this off so we can see what batteries this one takes. We've got AA for the remote, and this speaker system here also takes 4 AA batteries as well. And that is all there is to do in that stage, all there is to do in that pack, and all there is to do in that build. That's the build complete. So the thing we've got to do now is, fingers crossed, hope everything works. So I'm going to get some batteries into this, and let's see what happens. So here we have the finished Leopard tank. Looking pretty good. With Cuthbert von Schmidt in the lookout post there. Okay, let's start it up. So to do that, we could just pull this window down here. And as you can see, we've got a switch. Turn the switch on. And then bring over the remote control here. That's got an on button here, and you'll see that the light will click to say that's connected. Now I think the first thing we're going to do is this middle button here controls the steam. So when I turn the tank on, which I do by pressing this button here, and I click the steam, got to run for about 30 seconds, if you can hear me, for the steam to actually start coming out. So let's give it up to 30 seconds. As you can hear, it's making an almighty noise. And as you can see, the steam is now starting to come out of the tank. I don't know if that's coming up okay on camera. So that's that. Excellent. Let's turn that steam off. And now I'm going to have it going forwards and backwards. So, that's backwards. That's forwards. Now, as you can see, at the front of the tank, we've got these blinking lights here. And obviously, these mirrors go in and out. To make this go up and down, turn the tank on again. And we just press the up and down button here. So that's down and that's up.
And now the only other thing to show you is this little guide here. So if I shoot this, it actually makes the lights flash because it's got infrared beam. Hopefully. Let's try it now. Turn the tank on. And fire. Oh, we missed. Hang on a second. Lower the turret. Let's try again. There you go. We got it. Quite funny that time. So there you go. That's another build finish. So the only things I couldn't get working was the camera and the turret going left and right. Now, the turret is not a problem with the motor. I checked the motor separately. That works absolutely perfectly. So it's something between the control board, the remote, and the motor that's not working. So I have got another control board on the way. I'm hoping that will fix my camera problem. I didn't even know it had a camera in it, so I had to figure out where that came from. But there's no reason why the camera shouldn't work as well. I'm hoping it's the control board. So when I play that around, hopefully it'll work. But other than that, my gun went up and down. It steamed. It went backwards and forwards. It shot. It had an infrared beam. It did everything else. So it's the first time I did it. It's quite successful. But I'm hoping that those other two issues will get fixed by a replacement board. If it does, I'll probably put that on social media so you can see how that looks. But my son is having an enormous amount of fun playing with that in the garden now. That's going to go on the shelf, though. And it will probably never be used again because I just like the way it looks. But I really do hope you liked that video. If you did, please remember to give me a thumbs up. And if you haven't subscribed already, please remember to subscribe. Other than that, take care.